Okay, we're going to get started again. Next up, we have Hsiao-Yun Chang, who's going to talk about shad, also using the HRBMP data.
Good morning, my name is Hsiao-Yun. I'll be sharing our research work on shifting phenology in the Hudson River American shad. The Hudson River American shad is a diadromous species that migrates between freshwater and marine ecosystems. And the Hudson River estuary provides important spawning habitat for them. The Hudson River American shad used to support significant commercial fisheries for the East Coast of the United States. However, the shad population declined during the 20th century and the fishery has been closed since 2010, and no sign of recovery has been observed yet. Several factors have been identified for the declines of the shad population, including loss of habitat, overfishing, water pollution, and climate change. And of these factors, climate change can affect fish population in various ways. So it can cause distributional shift. In a previous study, we examined the spawning habitat for the shad in the Hudson River. We noted that the proportion of high density area is decreasing and the proportion of low density area is increasing. But these changes were more correlated with spawning stock biomass, but not environmental factors. Climate change is also likely to influence the timing of seasonal life history events, such as spawning. So phenology is the timing of seasonal life history events. The changes in phenology are considered as a common response of organisms to environmental changes. And phenology can be affected by environmental cues such as water temperature, and the inherent organismal traits can influence how different species respond to these cues. And fish body size has also been associated with the timing of spawning. So the changes in phenology, in spawning phenology, can have impact on population dynamics, which we'll get into in a minute. So in this study, we look at the temporal changes in spawning phenology with the biotic and abiotic factors. So we used spawning onset, spawning peak, spawning cessation, and duration to quantify spawning phenology and see how these changes are correlated with environmental factors and biological factors. So the data were collected from the Long River Survey, which is one of the surveys under the Hudson River Biological Monitoring Program. The Long River Survey targeted several life stages from eggs to young of year, but only eggs data are used in this study. And we also have water quality data collected from the Water Quality Survey, and river flow data collected by the USGS were also used in this study. So to quantify the timing of spawning, we used logistic models to fit relative cumulative relative daily CPV over day of year. So the spawning onset was defined as the day of year at 10% of the cumulative relative daily CPV, which means until that day of year, 10% of the eggs had been released. So it's considered the start of the spawning season. And spawning peak was defined as the day of year at 50% of the cumulative relative daily CPV. And spawning cessation was defined as the day of year at 90% of the cumulative relative daily CPU, which means until that day of year, 90% of the eggs had been released. So it's considered close to the end of the spawning season. And duration was defined as the time interval between spawning onset and spawning cessation. So we have estimates for every year from 1974 to 2017. The left panel shows the logistic models for each year. However, as Fred mentioned earlier, the sampling protocol changed over years, which resulted in inconsistent start and end survey dates. So in the top right panel, the gray and orange lines are the start and end survey dates for each year, and black and green lines are the first and last observations of shad eggs. So for the years when the survey started late, the survey might have missed the spawning onset, and the model would have estimates that were not biological meaningful. So the bottom right panel is an example that the survey might have missed spawning onset. So as a result, if the CPUE on the first day of year was higher than 10%, then it was assumed the survey missed the spawning onset and data of that year were excluded. So here are the results. The time series of the four spawning phenology metrics showed that the temporal changes in spawning onset were not significant, but spawning peak and spawning cessation were delayed, and consequently the spawning duration was prolonged. Although the temporal changes in spawning onset were not significant, it was found that the earlier spawning onset was associated with higher water temperature. So with increasing water temperature, the spawning onset could potentially advance significantly. And the delayed spawning peak and spawning cessation were correlated with smaller female spawner body size, but not environmental factors. So we observed earlier spawning onset associated with higher water temperature. Although the temporal changes in spawning onset were not significant, it could still have impacts on the population dynamics. So mismatch with zooplankton bloom has been observed for other species, which resulting in increased mortality and reduced recruitment. Although we don't have data to examine if there is a mismatch with zooplankton bloom for the shad in the Hudson River, a previous study observed a highly specialized larval diet among the Hudson River American shad, which could make them more vulnerable even in the absence of warming water temperature. And this